This video brought to you by RibTea.com, where their focus is to help men look better and feel better so they can be at their best all day, every day.
What we are doing is we want honesty, and we deal with a country, we want honesty. And I think with the new president, you're going to see much more honesty in the Ukraine. And that's what we're looking for. We're supporting a country. We want to make sure that country is honest. It's very important to talk about corruption. If you don't talk about corruption, why would you give money to a country that you think is corrupt?
Welcome back. I just wanted to take a quick moment to thank everybody that's donated to this channel, my Patreon, and my Subscribestar subscribers. Without all of you, none of this would be possible. I also wanted to let everybody know about my new website, DroneTechPolitics.com, that's going to be launching any day now. There, you're going to find exclusive content, live streams, discussion forums, and stories written by a brilliant team of writers that includes Robert Noir and SJG Perspective. Lastly, I want to let you all know about something I'm really excited about. I'm going to be attending the CNN Democrat debates on October 15th. While there, I'm going to be interviewing attendees and students on the Otterbein University campus. I'll, of course, be live streaming as well, so make sure to mark that on your calendar and stock up on booze. It should be entertaining. The media loves to bring up people like Kellyanne Conway and her now infamous quote about alternative facts, but they themselves are constantly engaged in manufacturing their own alternate version of reality and framing it in such a way as to get maximum benefit for the Democrat Party. We've seen them use these exact tactics to paint Trump as a by taking his quotes and completely misrepresenting them. They repeat these fake quotes over and over again to the point that your average person will always remember the alternate version and will likely just reject anybody who tries to claim otherwise as a right-wing conspiracy theorist.
What we really mean is he's promoting a conspiracy theory based on a bunch of lies that are being dredged up on the web.
We'll get right back to this media meltdown, but first let me just take a quick moment to thank this video's sponsor, RibTea.com. Guys, I know that we all need to constantly replace our t-shirts and underwear because we buy them cheap, in bulk, and at department stores. I'm here today to implore you to consider stepping up to a higher quality, immensely more comfortable choice. Not only are they American made, but RibTea is a company that values free speech and YouTubers like yours truly. If you need new t-shirts and underwear, and I think we all know that you do, treat yourself and try something that will not only feel amazing and improve your mood, but will also outlast anything that you bought from a department store. Head on over to ribtea.com/dronetech and make sure that you use the promo code DroneTech to get 20% off most items. If you would like me to give your channel or your website a shout out, simply make a purchase at ribtea.com/dronetech and send me the proof of purchase. Thank you. Well, today on NBC, they brought on one of their analysts to continue this DNC media tradition and literally just make up Trump quotes from the phone call between the president and the president of Ukraine. Yes, we can all see the transcript, and yes, we can all plainly see that none of these words were spoken, but NBC realizes the power of alternative facts.
This was part of a carefully orchestrated effort by a number of key administration officials to present an ultimatum to the Ukrainians. You've got to get involved in the 2020 election, help Trump win re-election, and if not, then you're not going to get the benefit of American support, including military support.
I just went back and reread the transcript, and nowhere in there did I see anything about ultimatums or getting involved in the 2020 election or helping Trump to win re-election. What I saw were discussions about corruption in Ukraine and getting reassurances that corruption would be dealt with. Remember, Trump said that he was concerned about giving all this money to Ukraine with all that corruption going on and not knowing that that money would be spent the way it was intended.
We're supporting a country. We want to make sure that country is honest. It's very important to talk about corruption. If you don't talk about corruption, why would you give money to a country that you think is corrupt?
Only later is Biden even mentioned, and it's only like two sentences about questions surrounding the firing of that prosecutor and the ending of that investigation.
Well, imagine, Savannah, if a president of the United States said to China, hey, you can invade your neighbors, or said to North Korea, you can build nuclear weapons if you do me a favor, though.
Let's be clear here. what that so-called reporter just reported is a total fabrication. It's literally just a fantasy about what he wished Trump had said. The key word here is imagine, as in imagination. Nothing in that phone call rose to anything near the picture this fraud is painting. What Trump did was ask the Ukrainian president to look into the firing of that prosecutor as an overall anti-corruption plan. Trump doesn't even know if Biden is going to be his opponent, and even if he did, why would he be worried about that? Have you seen Biden's rallies? They're pathetic. Beyond that, all of the Democrat presidential candidates put together haven't raised as much as the Trump campaign in the third quarter. Every single attempt to take Trump out since the day he took office has failed. Trump has every reason to be confident going into this election. Frankly, this fake news is so outrageous that not much needs said about it, but I do want to point out some other interesting facts that are withheld from the NBC viewer. The NBC host introduced this analyst as, quote, a former chief of staff at the CIA as well as the Department of Defense, but she withholds the fact that he actually worked for the Obama administration. It's not that unusual for the DNC media to be stacked with Democrat Party officials, but they never seem to disclose that fact for some odd reason. They also hide the fact that this analyst and the husband of the host both worked for Al Gore's 2000 presidential campaign, and they both took part in the efforts to recount Florida votes. Gee, why would the fact that these people were part of an effort to delegitimize the last Republican president be relevant at all? If it seems like this latest NBC deception seems familiar, that's because it is. This latest media attempt to mislead and deceive the public follows Congressman Schiff's alternate reality telling of Trump's phone call. This happened during his opening speech at the impeachment inquiry hearing, where he, like the NBC reporter, conjured up his own fictional account of that phone call.
We've been very good to your country, very good. No other country has done as much as we have. But you know what? I don't see much reciprocity here. I hear what you want. I have a favor I want from you, though. And I'm going to say this only 7 times, so you better listen good. I want you to make up dirt on my political opponent, understand lots of it. You know what I'm asking, and so I'm only going to say this a few more times, in a few more ways. And by the way, don't call me again. I'll call you when you've done what I asked.
Wow. Once again, we seem to see coordination between the media and the Democrats to plant a false memory into the heads of as many Americans as they can. If you're worried about Trump, then this should make you feel a little bit better. They wouldn't be doing any of this if they were confident they could take down Trump before the election. However, it also means that they're likely going to ramp up these tactics the closer we get to the election. Be sure to hit that like button and subscribe so you can keep up with all their latest scams and deceptive tactics. If you enjoy this channel and you want to see more content, please consider donating on PayPal or subscribing to me on Subscribestar or Patreon. Not only will you be joining others in helping me to fight back against media manipulation, but you'll also get access to exclusive content. You'll find all the links you need in the description or in the pinned comment. Thanks for watching. Keep coming back.